Hello, we'll be talking about heart today. See, heart is an important circulatory organ. The heart, if you look at the situation of the heart, it is situated in the middle mediastinum, that is, it is between the lungs. The area between the lungs is known as mediastinum. So the mediastinum is further divided into anterior, middle and posterior. So it is the organ which is present in the middle mediastinum. The heart, it is divided into right and left parts. The right side of the heart, it receives the deoxygenated blood from superior vena cava and the inferior vena cava. Now this deoxygenated blood, via the pulmonary trunk, it goes to the lungs where it gets oxygenated. The left side of the heart, it receives the oxygenated blood with the help of pulmonary veins. And from there, the blood, it goes to aorta, and this is how the whole body receives the blood. The heart has four chambers. We have the two atrias and the two ventricles. Now both AV pumps, both atrioventricular pumps, they form a cycle that is known as cardiac cycle. In cardiac cycle, there are here we'll be reading about two terms, that is systole and diastole. During diastole, there is relaxation of the ventricles, so there will be elongation of fibers of the ventricles. And during systole, there will be contraction of the ventricular fibers. Now, with the help of stethoscope, you can hear two types of sounds, that is lub and dub. Lub is heard once the blood from the atria, it goes to the ventricle. And dub, you will you can hear once the ventricle, from the ventricle, the blood is expelled out of the heart. So these are the two the heart sounds which you auscultate once you are auscultating it with the help of stethoscope. Now the heart, as I told you, it is lying in the middle mediastinum. So if we look at the histology aspect of the heart, it has three layers. We have the endocardium, which is the inner layer, then is the myocardium, which is made up of smooth muscle fibers, and we have the epicardium, that is the outer layer. Heart is present in the middle mediastinum. Now the heart is covered by a serous covering that is known as pericardium. This pericardium is further divided into visceral and parietal pericardium. The visceral pericardium is totally adherent with the heart, with the viscera. Then now if you look at the heart, see, the anteriorly you will have a few relations, that means the things which are present or the structures which are present onto the anterior aspect and to the posterior aspect. Anteriorly we have the sternum, we have the costal cartilages and ribs, they are forming its anterior relation. So it is in relation with 3 to 5th rib. Then posteriorly we have the structures which are forming the posterior mediastinum, like we have the esophagus, we have the azygous vein, we have the thoracic duct, so and the we have the vertebra, that is the thoracic vertebra, they are forming the posterior relations of the heart. The now the heart, now once grossly we talk about the heart, we have the heart has a few borders and it has surfaces. The heart has an anterior surface, it has a diaphragmatic surface, then it has right pulmonary surface and it has left pulmonary surface. The first, if I talk about the anterior surface is formed by the right ventricle. This is also known as the sternocostal surface because it is coming in relation with the sternum and the costal cartilages. Then we have the diaphragmatic surface. Diaphragmatic surface is known as diaphragmatic surface because it is coming in relation with the diaphragm. So the diaphragmatic surface is formed by both the right ventricle as well as the left ventricle. Both the ventricles, they contribute to formation of the diaphragmatic surface. Then we have the right pulmonary surface, which is formed by the right atrium, and we have the left pulmonary surface, which is formed by the left ventricle. So these are the four surfaces which you should know in heart. Then we have the borders. We have the right border, we have the left border, inferior border and superior border. So if I talk about the right border first, the right border is formed by the right atrium. So a line extending from the superior vena cava to the inferior vena cava, that forms your right border. The left border is formed by the right atrium, the left atrium and the left ventricle. The inferior border is formed by both the right ventricle and the part of left ventricle also. Superior border is formed between the both the atria, the right atria and the left atria. The border formed by both the atria, that forms the superior border. So these are the borders of the heart. When the heart has an apex, apex is formed by the left ventricle more and partly by the right ventricle. The apex is lying at the fifth intercostal space. Here, this is an area which is used for auscultation again. Then we have the base. Base is formed, base is just opposite to the apex, and the base is formed where the pulmonary veins are opening. It is onto the posterior aspect. So that is forming the base of the heart. Now the heart, this how we divide, it has an apex, it has a base, then it has surfaces, it has borders. Grossly you talk about heart in this way. The heart is supplied by the coronary arteries. We have the right coronary artery and the left coronary artery. The right coronary artery and the left coronary artery, they both are the branches which are rising from aorta. The right coronary artery, the right coronary artery will supply maximum of the right side of the heart, the right atrium, the right ventricle, the interventricular septum, the posterior one third of the interventricular septum is supplied by the right coronary artery. Then it is also supplying SA node and AB node. The left coronary artery, it supplies the left atrium, then left ventricle, part of right ventricle also. Then it is also going to supply the SA node and also the interventricular septum. The anterior two-third of interventricular septum is supplied by the left coronary artery. So this is how the blood supply goes. Then is the venous drainage. See the venous drainage of the heart, there is a big channel, all the veins of the heart, they drain into a sinus that is known as coronary sinus. And this coronary sinus, it opens into the right atrium. So this was about the venous drainage. Now if we see, so grossly you are seeing the heart from the outside. Now once you dissect it and you see the inner aspect of the heart, what all will you see? See the right, if I talk about the right atrium has three openings. It has an opening for SVC, superior vena cava. It will have an opening for inferior vena cava. And the coronary sinus, the whole of the venous blood is also draining there. So the opening of coronary sinus is also present there. Then once we open the right atrium, before opening it, there is a sulcus which we can feel, that is known as sulcus terminalis. So once you give an incision on sulcus terminalis and you open this right atrium, on the inner aspect there is supraventricular crest which you can see. Crista terminalis which you can see. Now the interior of the right atrium is divided into smooth part and rough part. Onto the rough part there are certain muscular projections, those are known as musculopectini. On the smooth part there is presence of a fossa that is known as fossa ovalis, and it has a margin that is known as limbus fossa ovalis. There is also presence of the tendon of Tadaro. There is a presence of the triangle of Koch that is also present in the interior of the right atrium. Similarly, in the left atrium also, there are not much to be seen in the left atrium. Then in the ventricles, if we, dissect the ventricles, here we see musculopectini. Then there are presence of cord-like structures, those are known as corda tendinae. Then there is presence of moderator band, and we also have a septomarginal trabeculae present. So this is how the gross of heart goes, and the physiology which I told you, the heart, how does it pump the blood out. So this is what you should know in heart. Thank you.